Welcome to all. We are going to learn the oxidation and the reduction. We already completed the reduction reaction. We are going to start the oxidation. The last lecture we learned about what is oxidation, what is oxidizing reagent and some oxidizing compounds or reagents, that is the chromate compound, Swan oxidation and Tollens reagent. Today we are going to learn the next oxidation reaction, that is called as a Baer-Willeger oxidation. The transformation of ketone into the ester and cyclic ketone into a lactone or the hydroxy acid by a peroxy acid was discovered as early as 1899 by a scientist named as A. Baer and Willeger. A wide range of oxidizing agent can be used to perform a Baer-Willeger oxidation. This reagent typically used to carry out this rearrangement are, the reagents are MCPBA and second one, that is peracetic acid, etc. The reactive or the strained ketone react with the hydrogen peroxide to form a lactone. That means in the Baer-Willeger reaction, these are some reactions. In this case, the aldehyde or the ketone which is reacted with the per acids, that is this is the per acid compound, this is the per carboxylic acid, it get converted to the carboxylic acid or the carboxylic ester. If the aldehyde is there, then which on reaction with the per acid, it get converted to a carboxylic acid, and whenever we use the ketone which is reacted with the peroxy acid or the per acid, it get converted to the ester. Okay, here these are another example. This is the cyclohexyl methyl ketone compound which is reacted with the per acid, it get converted to the ester, that is a methyl cyclohexane carboxylate compound. Okay, here it has a two condition, either this oxygen which is attached to the CCH3 bond, in between the CCH3 bond, or this is attached to the cyclohexyl or the carbonate bond like here. Okay, that means it has the possibility of the formation of cyclohexene OCO bond or the COOCH3 bond. Whenever there is a bond between the CO and CH3, that time the compound which is formed, that is called as a methyl cyclohexane carboxylate, and whenever there is a addition of the oxygen in between cyclohexyl and the carbonyl, that time it is called as a cyclohexyl acetate compound. Let me see the mechanism of the Baer-Willeger oxidation. Mostly in the Baer-Willeger oxidation, we use the per acid. Okay, mostly the acid which is used, that is a MCPBA. Okay, let me learn the mechanism of this reaction. You can see here, this is the ketone and which is reacted with the per acid, that is CH3COOH, that is called as a per acid or per carboxylic acid. Okay, here what happened, this oxygen which has a lone pair which donates their electron to this carbonyl carbon, at the same time this electron is abstracted by this oxygen, oxygen becomes negatively charged. You can see in the red arrow. Then what happened, there is a formation of like this structure. Then this oxygen which donates their electron towards this carbonyl compound of the ketone, this oxygen becomes positively charged. Then here for the removing this positive charge, this hydrogen which, sorry, this hydrogen get removed. Okay, there is a formation of minus H plus, and after minus H plus, there is a formation of like this. Okay, here you can see in the red arrow, what happens? This oxygen, which donates their electron to this carbon, and there is a formation of the carbon oxygen double bond. At the same time, yeah, there is increasing valency of this carbon, and that's why this R group is exchanged. R group is, by breaking this CR bond, this R group is shifted to this oxygen, and the same time the bond between this per acid OO going to break, and all these electrons are accepted by this oxygen. This is the unstable intermediate step. Okay, here this is the like this, and by that means there is a formation of what, like this compound RCOOR. What happened here? This, whenever this unstable compound is formed, intermediate is formed, this R group is shifted to this oxygen. Okay, that means there is a breaking of CR bond, and this R group is shifted to here. Whenever this R group shifted to this oxygen, there is a breaking of oxygen-oxygen bond. All these electrons accepted by this oxygen of the per acid, and this oxygen of the carbonyl be donors electron to the formation of the carbon oxygen double bond over here. Okay, and here there is a formation of our product, that is RCOOR plus CH3COOH. That is, per acid get converted to the acid, and this ketone get converted to the what, ester. There is a formation of the ester compound. Okay, let me learn the relative migration tendencies. That means what we learn in the next example, that is here. Here we learn the example of this compound. That means whenever this type of compound is there, that is the cyclohexene methyl ketone type of compound, this is reacted with the per acid, then what happens? It has a possibility of the formation of the two types of the product, either this oxygen attached to the CH3 group or the cyclohexene group. Then which product is major and which one is the minor, which can be decided by the migratory aptitude. That is what, the relative migration tendency. Okay, that means here the increasing tendency to migrate is what, the hydrogen, then tertiary alkyl compound, then secondary alkyl or which is equal to the phenyl compound, and the primary alkene, and the last one is the methyl compound. Okay, that is the oxygen which is attached to those compound which has the bulky or more substituted, and the migration of the smallest compound which can be done, that is hydrogen, then tertiary alkyl or the secondary alkyl or primary alkyl or the methyl. This is the arrow of the increasing tendency to migrate towards this oxygen. Okay, that means therefore the product of the pair will include oxidation of the cyclohexyl methyl ketone, which we learned earlier, will be cyclohexyl acetate, because a secondary alkyl group is more likely to be migrate than a methyl group. Okay, secondary alkyl group is more likely to be migrative here. Okay, secondary alkyl, this is the secondary alkyl compound, this is more migrating than the methyl compound, that's why this is the major product. This is our major product. Okay, that is like when a migratory aptitude says that here the hydrogen first to be migrated, then the tertiary, then secondary. That means here in this case the cyclohexyl is the secondary alcoholic compound, and that's why here this is migrated, and that's why we get this is the major product according to the migrating aptitude or migrating tendency. Okay, next we learn the application of the Bayer-Willeger. This Bayer-Willeger oxidation has a great synthesis utility as it permits the transformation of the ketone into ester. An oxygen atom is inserted next to the carbonyl group. This reaction is applicable to both the cyclic ketone and also the acyclic ketone. The oxidation of the cyclic ketone occurs with the ring expansion. Whenever the cyclic ketone is there, that time shows what? Ring expansion, and form a lactone, as illustrated in the conversion of the cyclohexanone to the lactone by this method. That means here you can see, if the cyclic ketone is there, in presence of MCPBA, that is called as a metachloroperbenzoic acid. This is the per acid, okay, in presence of CH2Cl2 as a solvent. Here in Bayer-Billinger, here we use per acid, mostly here we use the MCPBA, that is metachloroperbenzoic acid. That time here the oxygen, which is attached to the more substituted alkyl compound, that means not this side, here this is attached to the this side, oxygen is attached to the more substituted compound or secondary group. We'll already discuss the migrating tendency of the oxygen, okay. That's why here this oxygen, which is mostly attached to this more substituted compound, more substituted side, and that's why here we get that this type of the lactone compound. What is important, whenever the acyclic compound is there, that time the product is the ester, and whenever we use the cyclic ketone, which on oxidation with the MCPBA, we get the lactone compound. Okay, next topic is the oxidation of the alkene with the peroxy acids. That means we learn whenever we use the convert aldehyde or the ketone into the ester or the acid or the lactone, that time we use the peroxy acids, and that process is known as a Bayer-Billinger oxidation reaction. Let me learn same oxidizing reagent which is acts on the alkene compound. Okay, here we use the peroxy acids on the alkene compound. In the Bayer-Billinger reaction, we use peroxy acid on the aldehyde or the ketonic compound. Okay, whenever this alkene, which is reacted with the peroxy acids, we get epoxide. This is very important. Okay, whenever aldehyde or the ketone, which is reacted with the peroxy acids, we get ester, acid, or what? The lactones. But whenever here this peroxy acid, which is reacted with the alkene, that time we get the epoxide. Okay, here this is the mechanism of the epoxidation of the alkene. What happened here? In this case, this double bond carbon, which has, by breaking this one bond, this is shifted to this oxygen. At the same time, there is a breaking of this bond, and here you can see in this arrow, there is a breaking of OO bond. This bond of the peroxy acids, this bond is shifted to here, and there is a formation of the carbon oxygen double bond. Okay, and here this carbon CA double bond O, which breaking this bond, which abstract the proton, there is a formation of the OH compound. At the same time, by removing this hydrogen, this bond is shifted to this carbon, and there is a formation of the like this ketonic compound. You can see this red colored arrow. Here what happened? This is the peroxy acids. Here this is the peroxy acids R C O C O O O H. Okay, here what happened? There is a carbon alkene which has a double bond, which breaking this bond donates their electron to this oxygen. At the same time, what happened? There is a breaking of this oxygen-oxygen bond, and all these electrons is shifted to the formation of the carbon-oxygen double bond. And whenever this carbon-oxygen double bond is formed over here, this carbon-oxygen double bond is going to break, and which abstract this hydrogen, and there is a formation of the OH compound. Whenever this hydrogen is going to abstract it, there is a breaking of this bond. Here all these electron is shifted to this carbon of the alkene, and there is a formation of this type of the epoxide. And here when this epoxide is formed, our byproduct is the acid RCOOH. This is our byproduct. Okay, here the addition of oxygen to the alkene is a stereospecific reaction. That means what? Whenever you take here the cis-2-butene compound, which on reaction with the peroxy acids, we get the cis product. Okay, and whenever you take here the trans-2-butene, that time which is reaction with the peroxy acid, we get the trans product only. That's why this is the stereospecific reaction. Okay, then here you can see here this is the addition of the oxygen atom from the either side of the trigonal planar cis alkene leads to the same compound, that is a meso product. That is, whenever you use here the Z-2-butene compound, which is reacted with or oxidation with the peroxy acid or peracetic acid, we get the two type of the product. That is what? Both of these are the cis product and these are the meso compound. And whenever you take here the E-type of the alkene, which on oxidation with the peracetic acid, we get the both product are the oxygen is added to the above the plane and or the oxygen added to the below the plane. That time here we get the enantiomers. Okay, this is about the what stereochemistry of the alkene or epoxidation of the alkene. Okay, next we are going to learn, that is the hydroxylation of the alkene. This hydroxylation of the alkene we will learn in the next lecture. Today here we stop. Today we are going to learn, that is what, the Baer-Villiger reaction and the epoxidation of the alkene using a same oxidizing reagent, that is what, peroxy acids. Here we use the different types of the peroxy acids, either MCPBA, that is called as a metachloroparbenzoic acid, or peracetic acid. Both of the, or here we use also the another oxidizing agent, that is H2O2. All are the peroxy acids. By using this peroxy acid, we convert aldehyde and the ketone into the ester or the lactone compound and the alkene into the epoxide compound. Thank you very much for watching this lecture. And next time we will learn the hydroxylation of the alkene. Thank you very much.